ChoiceScript underscore stats.txt file is what the show stats button will reference. It can be completely blank. You can even hide this button by editing the HTML code inside of index.html. But for now, just leave it as is. Remove all the variables that no longer exist in startup.txt, which means leadership and strength in this case. In fact, remove everything except star stat underscore chart. If you want to keep the code simple, you could just show the exact value of the variables. For example, skill would just be a number, but I want to define it better, so I'm going to give a word description for different range of that value. So what do all these code mean? Line 1 says to create a temporary variable called skill underscore text and let it be empty, symbolized by two double quotes. This variable doesn't have to be created in startup.txt because it will only be and can only be used in this context, unlike the variables listed in startup.txt. Notice that the ChoiceScript syntax here is star temp as opposed to star create. Line 2 checks if the value of skill is less than 2, which means a negative value, 0 or 1. If that's true, the engine will look at the lines of code underneath it that has one more level of indentation than the current star if line. If you write bibliographies for essays, think of it like a hanging indent per if statement. Suppose skill equals 1, then the statement skill less than 2 is true, and the engine will look at line 3. Line 3 says to set the value of skill underscore text to beginner as opposed to the default value of empty. Line 4 has the same amount of indent as 3, so it will be looked at next. It says to jump to a later part of the scene file that has the label chart. If you skip ahead, that will be at line 12. Line 5 is a related but slightly different conditional check as line 2. It is dependent on the previous if statement in its sequence. Suppose skill equals 1, then the code block for the first if will be run, while the code block for this else if won't be. It's important that you use star else if instead of star if here, because otherwise the skill underscore text variable will be changed again, because 1 is smaller than 2, but also smaller than 7. Note that the star else on line 8 is another related but slightly different conditional check. That one is for all other case if all previous if or else if statements are evaluated to be false. This entire chain of conditional checks should be mutually exclusive. Suppose we already jumped down to line 12, then line 13 says to insert an empty line between the previous displayed text and the next part in the game. Technically, all you need to do is manually add a blank line between star label space chart and star stat underscore chart. But this is explicitly telling the game engine to go to the next line. Most of the time, it will help you break up a long paragraph. Line 14 tells the game engine to format the following block of code a certain way. There are alternative ways to display the value of variables, but if you are just starting out, stick to this method. Line 15 says to display the value of variable skill underscore text as plain text, and to label it skill level. Line 16 tells the engine to add another blank line. If you check the stats screen in the game, you'll see that the text has some breathing room above and below it instead of being crammed between the buttons Return to the Game and Next.